People seem to have been enjoying the Internet Historian reaction, so we're going to be watching another one today, but feel free to leave any suggestions down in the comments below. Today we'll be watching The Failure of Dashcon. I don't know anything about this, didn't even know what happened.
In March of 2013, a group of Tumblr users come up with a brilliant idea. Dashcon. A convention.
Wait, is that... Is Tumblr still a thing? I thought it removed all porn, and then it stopped being a thing, or did it come back? I never used Tumblr.
Mentioned specifically for and by Tumblr users. This...
Oh, that's gonna go well.
...is their story.
Things rarely go well when it's, like, created by the fans themselves.
Dashcon, wow, hosted at the Renaissance Marriott in Chicago. Only $65 for the weekend. Wow, epic panel lineup. Wow, welcome to Night Vale reading. LGBTQQIP2SAA+. Massive ball pit. Steam-powered giraffe live show. The Baker.
Who the fuck is Steam-powered Giraffe? I'm sorry if they're, like, a really famous. I don't know anything about bands. But sick name.
Street babes. And friendly memes, you bet.
That was dated even when this came out, I'm pretty sure. Don't put memes as a selling point. Memes go so fast.
Expect 5,000 people. We'll see you there.
No, you won't. Whoosh.
Here comes Friday, and a big fat serving of reality. About 500 people show up and...
Go back.
Here comes Friday, and a big fat serving of reality.
Who the fuck is all over this woman's dress? Huh? Oh, and she's wearing an actual... I somehow missed the mask on her face! I was too distracted by all the ones on her dress. She's literally wearing the face as a mask. Must be a fan.
Reality. About 500 people show up at 9 a.m.
I don't think there's any commentary I can apply to this. Moving along.
PM. But nothing is scheduled until 1 p.m, so people just wait around for the next 4 hours.
So at what point did you decide that this is what you wanted to do with your life?
I didn't, it just kind of happened.
Yep, that's usually how it goes. When you get in those fandoms, you kind of just end up there.
Thug life shows you.
Turns out steam-powered giraffe cancelled months ago.
Smart.
Sorry. If you bought special tickets, no refunds though, lol. Check out the games room. One TV, one console. Perfect for up to 7,000 people. Here's that ball pit you were looking forward to.
Free Palestine! Death to Israel!
What the fuck? Wait. Went from ball pit to politics. Okay. Also, someone's definitely peed in that ball pit already, I'm sure.
Death to Israel! Free Palestine!
Overall, it's a pretty fucking slow day.
Okay, so you're dressed up as the Batman movie shooter. What made you choose this costume?
Well, what? Hang on. Costume? Yeah, that's just what he wears. Also, that's not what the Batman shooter looked like. Didn't he have his hair dyed as, like, orange and whatnot?
What made you decide to dress up as the Prime Minister of Israel to this convention?
Who the fuck is this guy with the camera?
Then by...
To dress up as the Prime Minister of Israel to this convention.
I say dress for the job you want.
Then
he took it in stride. That was a good way to answer that question.
By 9 p.m., disaster strikes. The bill for the venue hasn't even been paid. The hotel wants it immediately, or the doors will be shut and the convention is over.
You think all those people have spare money on hand? Really? Now the furries, I would believe it. Do you know how expensive those costumes are? I bet they have money to spare. I don't know how they get it, but they do. They're not wrong. That's extortion. Huh? Really? You're gonna just use the salute?
But
from Hungry
they
Games?
Raise the money, and the con continues. Saturday. Huh? Artists and stall holders who paid $150 each for their tables aren't selling anything because their customers just donated all of their cash. Tumblr's turned on the convention completely.
The destruction of this
convention
is dedicated to all of the women whose
bank account
have been ruined and ruled by it.
Money.
That's the most exercise she's gotten.
PayPal.
They call Dashcon a scam and try to have certain events shut down. Mark Does Stuff, a gay Hispanic panelist,
Hi, I'm Mark.
Is sent death threats because they think he's a straight white male who's misappropriating the gay for profit. Pacific Rim is illegally played to an audience of 100. Tumblr sends tweets to Del Toro to get them in trouble. The Dr. Horrible sing-along blog sing-along is cancelled due to copyright concerns. Then, the main event. As long as we get to see a live reading from Welcome to Night Vale, it'll all be okay.
We're here for the live reading of Welcome to the Night Vale. It is 12:50 right now, and they're still not here.
Okay, so basically, Night Vale just walked.
What?
What?
We're all gonna sign together, okay? So, one, two...
While everyone is still sitting in that room waiting for the show to start, they changed the rules on the website so that there are no refunds. But don't worry, there's a...
Now that's scummy. But what do you mean, like, we're all gonna take a sigh together? Huh? What is that gonna... demand your money back.
Silver lining. Everyone who paid extra to see Welcome to Night Vale is entitled to a free extra hour in the ball pit.
Oh, well, it's all forgiven then. Get an extra hour in that ball pit where someone has most definitely already pissed inside of.
This is what your $17,000 went to.
That you feel
and
dumb.
And then a meme is born.
I don't think they're ready for this one. Jump in the pit.
By the early afternoon, the vendors pack up and leave. Some shitty panels happen.
Whoa. Hang on. Wait, is this the first one? Okay. Roles of gender roles beta. Huh? Fertility? Maybe infertile. If not able to reproduce, treated as sexless. What the fuck? Hang on. The Omega? Considered lower class. What? Extremely fertile, only during heat. Do people go into heat? Do humans go into heat? Huh? Idealized and highly prized as breeders. What the fuck? Alphas. Top of society, second only to alpha males. Can impregnate others. Genitalia features a knot. Wait, I'm in the way, I know, but... Genitalia features a knot ensures pregnancy. Female alphas have other options. Female alphas have other options. Hermaphroditic tentacle. Okay, we're just. Alright. Okay, that was clever. I'll give them that. The LGBTQA. Q&A. That's clever.
Because again, they don't have any cash, they're giving out free hotel mints as prizes. The teenage unpaid helpers, who are promised free meals, aren't given anything and go hungry. There's a full-on organizer meltdown. And Tumblr finds out that the main artwork used for the convention is in fact stolen copyright material.
Man, that's just on brand.
The unthinkable happens. The ball pit starts to deflate.
No!
And someone pisses in it.
I fucking called it! I knew someone was gonna piss in it. It's a ball pit. That's what you do.
Sunday. The ball pit is taken away. Also, Tumblr finds out that Random Acts, a charity that Dashcon claims to be partnered with, isn't in fact partnered at all. Which means, by the way, they've just been pocketing the money. The organizers host an official apology panel.
Isn't that illegal? Are you fucking crying? What the fuck?
And we take full responsibility for the parts that were us.
Then where's their money?
We are first timers, but we intend to learn from our mistakes to make 2015 even better.
Maybe if you're first-timers, don't do a convention of this size. Maybe work on an established convention. Huh? Huh?
Here's a quick summary of that.
So like
I blame somebody, otherwise it's all my fault. Fuck that.
And everything is closed by 1 p.m. Since Dashcon, there have been many rumors online that the whole thing was an out-and-out scam. So I did some detective work to see whether it was true. I think what I found proves that even if the staff didn't set out to scam people, they did opportunistically steal and lie. Prepare for some high-quality autism. Dashcon had a written agreement to pay $40,000 plus some change to the Renaissance Hotel Marriott. They paid $20,000 before the thing began, so they had a balance of $20,000 still remaining. They told the hotel that 5,000 to 7,000 people would be attending, and could they please pay as the door sales came in.
I can't believe the hotel agreed to this. I would never agree to something like that. Oh yeah, you can pay it off as it goes. No! Do pre-ticket sales, do something!
As a financially risky move, the Marriott agreed verbally, but not in writing. On the first day, the hotel sees at most 1,000 people. They know that Dashcon's door sales are fucked, so they enforce immediate payment as per their written contract.
Okay, that's pretty fucking smart of Marriott.
Dashcon does not have the funds. And here's where it gets interesting. Dashcon claims they only have $3,000 in cash. So at 9 p.m, Dashcon staff gather everyone into one room to beg for the remaining $17,000. Let's do a head count. 33, 129, 120, maybe another 33 here in case there are people on the margin, and we'll add 10% to be generous.
Damn, he did his work!
It's unlikely that there are more than 350 people in this room. Now we know they reached their goal.
Almost got shut down.
Really?
We need to raise $17,000.
Really?
Yes.
That's pretty cool. Did you do it?
We did it in under an hour.
Really?
Yeah.
They received donations by PayPal and cash, but only a small fraction in cash. Let's be generous and say 1/10 of the room at most. You can see people donating in the footage, and it's probably much less. So even if each cash donor is giving $20, which again, generous, that's only $700 total. Therefore, the other $16,000 or so is in electronic payments. Now let's look at this leaked list of transactions. Hold on. They made most of their payment in cash. Almost $12,000.
So they had more money on hand. So why were they trying to get even more?
But they only could have got $700 from the donors, and they only had $3,000 in cash. So where did the rest of it come from? It's door sales revenue, not donations, meaning they lied about only having $3,000 in the first place. They actually had at least $10,000. Now, here are the transactions that come from the PayPal MasterCard. Let's take that from the total owed. And what we get is the following. In a best case scenario, of the donated $17,000, at most, they spent less than $7,000 keeping the place open. They spent over $2,000 on themselves and their own accommodation. And the remaining $9,000 or so, they pocketed.
Are these people in jail?
Also, they're liars.
Because I was on stage for an hour in front of 5,000 people.
5,000 people, okay.
In a room.
Is there 5,000 people here?
A riot.
A riot. I don't think Tumblr users are capable of truly rioting. Yep, that's doing something, alright. What is this accomplishing?
But there's one last thing I want to touch on. As part of the merchandising, an official Dashcon DVD is listed. And it's possible that a copy exists out there somewhere, and I need to find it. So I want to put a $100 bounty out for anyone who might have a copy. It doesn't need to be the physical DVD, just a copy of the file itself. The hunt is on.
Well, I hope that exists. Wait, there's more. Well, I hope you enjoyed. And if you're interested in more, consider subscribing. Also, I do stream on Twitch, play games, and watch some videos with the chat. So, hope you enjoyed, and leave any recommended videos for the future down in the comments below. Talk to you later. Bye.